Hey, what's up guys, Sanvid here. So today we are going to talk about Samsung Galaxy A80 versus the iPhone XS Max. Now why we are comparing these phones is because the A80 is selling on a great price these days and you can actually get them at a killer deal in some of the flash sales. Now A80 came around a year ago, it was April 2019 and the iPhone XS Max came around about 2 years back. Now I have divided this video into some segments in regards to the display, the camera, the overall performance and the price point. We will be comparing all of these in this video, so make sure to watch it till the end. And also if you want to watch the full review of Samsung Galaxy A80, you can watch that on my channel or I'll link it in this video. Also if you are new to the channel, make sure to subscribe to the channel for such amazing content. And if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. It really helps the YouTube algorithm. Now let's start with the on-paper spec sheet. Now the Samsung Galaxy A80 has a 6.7-inch Super AMOLED display with a 48-megapixel triple camera setup. It also consists of 8 gigs of RAM along with Snapdragon 730 processor. Now do note that Snapdragon 730 is a mid-range processor and not a flagship one. Flagships are generally in the 800 series and they would generally perform better than the 730 ones. And on the battery side, it's 3700 mAh. Now moving on to the iPhone XS Max, we have a 6.5-inch AMOLED panel with an Apple A12 Bionic chip inside along with 4 gigs of RAM. But when you are reviewing devices in a different ecosystem, things tend to vary a lot. In case of Apple and iOS, the customizations are so good and so clean that you will never feel that other phones in the same price bracket and even lower price brackets have higher specifications because they do the optimization so well. But before we deep dive into that, let's first go on to our first segment, the displays. Now the displays on both the phones are excellent to say the least. The Samsung Galaxy A80 does not have a notch here. That's a big plus point thanks to its camera setup. And you will also notice that there is no speaker grill in the front facing of the screen. So there are no bezels at all. So in case of an aesthetic feel, the A80 certainly wins here. In the case of the display quality, I would say both are great. It depends on the color reproduction, which one you prefer. Most people would prefer the iPhone because it's a more subtle color reproduction and it's a good quality display overall. Now, as Apple produces flagships, there are some additional features in the iPhone that A80 does not have. For example, the Face ID. That's something that A80 cannot incorporate and you are stuck with something like an in-screen fingerprint sensor. Now it's not as accurate or as fast as the Face ID on the iPhone. And in general, the Face ID on the iPhone XS Max outperforms by a huge difference to the in-screen fingerprint on the A80. And there is no other option there. They could not do the iris scanner or the Face ID because of the triple camera setup that is on the back and it rotates forward. So it is hella slow than what you would compare on the iPhone XS Max. So in terms of unlocking, I would say iPhone is miles ahead in this case. Now this was all about the front of the phone. Let's move on to the actual processing power. Now as I said earlier, the Snapdragon 730 is a mid-range chip. You cannot compare that to a Snapdragon 800 series or the newer iPhones that are out there. If you compare it with iPhone 7, 8, it would definitely do better. But in comparison to the A12 Bionic or the A13 chip that is currently out there, it stands nowhere. The Snapdragon 730 is more focused on the battery saving aspect of it and is a mid-range chip with which you can do decent amount of gaming and in general you won't face any lag at all. And for most consumers, this is absolutely fine. Now I would also like to say that on max settings, on Call of Duty, PUBG, any game that you like, you can play that on Samsung Galaxy A80 without any issues. Now for the iPhone, it generally kills any device out of the park when it comes to the processing power and the GPU. Now this is done because of the iOS optimizations, but for a mid-range chip, it stands nowhere in the processing power and Apple completely destroys that here. But as I said before, if you are a regular consumer and you just want some part of gaming, some part of YouTube, I think that's enough for most people. A80 will stand just fine. Now with the build quality, Apple has a decent build quality with stainless steel around, and you can also watch a Jerry Rick video in which he throws the iPhone XS Max on the ground and it does not break even after subsequent drops. Now with the A80, there are some concerns here. The triple camera on the back, it's a mechanical thing. They can be faulty, they can have some issues in the future. As of now, I have been using this phone for a lot of time. I have faced no issues except that whenever I keep my phone on a table, it fails to open. You want a safer design, it's always the iPhone. They have tried and tested it for a lot of units, for a lot of years, and they generally do not fail. Now moving on to the actual camera itself. Now the selling point of A80 is its camera. Now one thing that you should know, that the back camera here that is treated as a front camera is not the same. So they do add some software optimizations when you switch on the front mode, and in general they could have done a better job with a back camera and with a solid design like this, in which the back camera has been utilized for the front facing selfie camera, but they have failed to do so. It's decent, don't get me wrong here, but it's not as good as you would expect it to be. Now this is something to do with software, and it may get fixed in the future, because it just like puts on a beauty mode and my image is just not that great in general. The back camera is good. I have taken some shots on both the phones and they both look decent. In low light, the A80 struggles to perform as good as the flagships, but in broad daylight, it's great, and in sunlight as well, it can take some great shots. Now the dynamic range on both the phones is great. Now iPhone XS Max does have a flagship camera, and the processing Apple does on the software side is so amazing that here it wins as well. The images are generally clear and crisp, and the portrait shots you get are amazing. Like portrait mode on the iPhone is so great. On the night mode though, iPhone also struggles. Night mode isn't that great and the pictures can be really, really grainy. And similar is the case with A80. So in daylight, they both perform great. The iPhone just is a tad better than the A80, but in low light, I would say they both struggle in general. On the video front, there is no match for the iPhone XS Max here. Even the flagships of OnePlus and Samsung, they can't compete with the video quality of Apple here. It's one of the best in the industry, if not the best, and it is by a huge margin. Now talking about the price points, you can get the iPhone XS Max for about 65,000 for the 64GB variant and around 75,000 for the 256GB variant. Now I know this is a higher price than the A80, which is around 31,000-32,000, and in flash sales around 22,000. If you get the A80 at 22,000 rupees, I think it's a great deal. It's like 3 times less the price of an iPhone, so it's a good bargain. But if you do get the A80 for anything above 35,000, I would not recommend that phone. So the choice is up to you. Do let me know if you buy any of these phones and how was your experience. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to this channel, please make sure to subscribe, as I said in the start of the video. That was all for today, guys. If you want that I should do any other reviews, do let me know. I'll do that. Thank you.